What does an RA value tell you about the quality of the surface? And what are the limits of this method? I will explain you in this video. With this video, we would like to direct system designers and engineers who are working in a highly hygienic environment. In our daily work, we figure in a lot of cases that there's a lot of explanation needed with regard to the term RA value on the one hand and quality on the other hand. And because in a lot of cases, it's considered the same. So that's why I would like to show you the differences. I brought you here a standard measurement device for an RA value. So with this one, you can determine the topography of a surface. And it works in this way that you have a measurement head like this. You will have to place a sample underneath and you can lower then the measurement head so that the diamond tip, which is in front, is touching the surface, which is at the end of the day self-aligning. So this device gives you also some aid with regard to the adjustment. On the other upper picture here, you can see a cross-section of this measurement head, which consists at the end of the day of some electronics and of the diamond tip in front. And in another picture, you can see the actual travel path that this diamond tip is performing on the surface. And the RA value at the end of the day is nothing else but the arithmetic average of the displacement of the diamond tip on this surface. So with this, you have an information about the roughness of the surface. But where are the limits of this method? So when you take a look at this picture here, that shows you a microscopic picture of the diamond tip needle over a given surface. And you can figure from this picture that there's certainly a significant difference with regard to the structure of the surface and the size of a diamond tip. So actually it's very difficult to measure with this diamond tip the real structure of the surface. Plus, when you figure that the diamond tip has roughly a diameter of 1 micrometer and it's touching the surface with a force of roughly 1 millinewton, this is creating a tremendous force and tremendous impact on a metal surface, especially when you consider the different hardnesses of a diamond and of a stainless steel surface or a stainless steel electropolished surface such as this one here. So you can see from this upper picture that it's creating actually traces on this surface. But what you actually would like to do is you would like to measure the surface. Instead of measuring the surface only, you are creating your own surface. So by this, you can see that there are certainly some limitations. Furthermore, when you see this upper picture, you see different surfaces which show you the same RA value. But certainly all these surfaces have different cleaning properties, as you can figure. Yeah? The upper one is pretty easy to clean, the lower one is pretty difficult to clean. But that is also an indication about the quality of a surface. So with this picture, you can figure that on the one hand, quality of a surface, cleanability of a surface, and RA value do not that much have in common. But it's a very standard method to determine the quality, or as we now figured, only the RA value of the surface. So I hope I could show you the difference between the RA value on the one hand and the quality, or let's say cleanability, of a surface on the other hand. I would be very happy to receive also your question in case something might not become very clear, or if you would certainly subscribe to our YouTube channel. Not much more to say than thanks a lot for your attention, and I'm happy to welcome you in other videos again.